When I was pregnant for my second son, the doctors, I had complications with my first son, had a C-section. Second son, I wanted to go natural. And the doctor said, you can't. I thought, with God, nothing shall be called impossible. And I said, Lord, and I asked him. And he said, go for it. So the whole 9 months, they were concerned that I was going to have an issue or rupture, blah, blah, blah. Came time to give birth. I went into labor, and they told me my son was dead. They said, he is dead, and we have to give you an emergency C-section. I said, my son is not dead. My son is going to live because God has promised me that when he gives seed, he's going to cause it to come forth. And then I told my husband to punch the guy in the face. So, well, you know, I know that wasn't right, but we have to get angry at the enemy, right? We have to get mad at the devil. We can't let him take our stuff. Amen? We have to punch him in the face with the word of the Lord. And so my husband's like, Trisha, I can't punch him in the face. I said, punch him in the face. I said, because our baby is alive and he's not dead. So when it came time to give birth, it was like there was such warfare. And, you know, you're scared. You hear what the doctors are saying. But I said, no, the Lord told me. Now, let me tell you the strategy he gave me. I was pregnant, and for 9 months, the Lord had me speak over my body, over every part of my body, and decree the word every day for 9 months. See, what is that? There's a cycle. The Lord is telling us a strategy of the word. You've got to get the word back in you. You speak to that thing. You call that thing. And you say you will live and not die. You prophesy life to that thing. And so when I was in the labor room, the doctors were scrubbing to give me the section. And of course, there was a movie, Sybil, out at that point. It seemed like I had multiples. But I started pushing, and I'm talking and doing all this crazy stuff. And I started pushing, and I gave birth to my son. And for those of you who know, he had a 9.9 Apgar score. The Lord says that with God, nothing shall be called impossible. There's that deliverance. My mind had to get delivered. I had to allow the Spirit of the Lord. You have to understand something. I was operating in signs and wonders, but I was bound. My thought process was not awakened to the truth, the revelation of who I am. The devil's not going to determine my destiny or who I am. And that's what so many of us have done. We're letting the devil tell us who we are. When God says you are the righteousness of Christ Jesus, you are the head and not the tail, that you have a breaker anointing upon you, that you can speak to those dead, dry bones and prophesy resurrection life. That's the people who we are. We cannot be passive any longer. God is breaking us out of that passivity because of situations that have caused you to pull back. God's pulling that slumbering spirit off of us. He's pulling off that slumber. He's pulling that blanket off, that thing that is trying to lock you down. But I got news for you. God is unlocking. He is unlocking that hindrance that the enemy has put you on, that's placed upon you. You know, one of the definitions for me for curses is empowered to fail. Well, I'm not in agreement that I'm empowered to fail because I have the blood of Jesus and I have the mind of Christ. So with that, we started to really teach on it. And I had started to really press into the Lord. I said, God, you said that I am your daughter. You said that you love me with an everlasting love. I have lived nothing but defeat. I was told all my life you won't make it. But God said you will. And that's where we have to choose the word of the Lord. The word of the Lord breaks through. He's the breaker. One of the words for El Shaddai is he is the God of utter destruction. He will destroy that which is trying to take you out. Whoa.